Now let us solve another problem on Myhill-Neroth theorem, which is different from the earlier two problems, and the DFA given is this one. There are six states A, B, C, D, E and F, and there are three final states C, D and E and initial state A, and I have already drawn the transition table which is this. Now the step one is drawing the table. Now we have six states A, B, C, D, E and F. Let us draw this table. A, B, C, D, E, F, and draw like this. A, B, C, D, E and F. Ignore this first one and this last one and draw like this. Now as we have done in the previous examples, repeat the same process. Now we have the cell B and A. A is non-final state, B is non-final state, so leave it. C, A. C is final state, A is non-final state, so mark it. Similarly, C, B. C is final state and B is non-final state, so mark it. D, A. D is final, A is non-final, mark it. D and B. D is final, B is non-final, so mark it. If you look at D and C, both are final state, but our condition is only one should belong to final state and another should belong to non-final state. Here both are final states, so leave it. So DC remains unmarked and EA. E is final, A is non-final. Mark it. EB, EC, both are final states, so don't mark it. Similarly, ED, both are final states, so don't mark it. A and F, both are non-final states, so don't mark it. FB, both are non-final states, so don't mark it. F and C, one is final state and one is non-final state, so mark it. Similarly, F and D, F and E. Now step 2 is completed and we have to implement step 3, and after completion of step 2, our table looks like this. There are 5 unmarked cells in this table. Now let us consider B and F, or FB, FB cell. And there are two input symbols, 0 and 1. Let us consider delta of F on 0, which is, and delta of B on 0, and delta of F on 1, delta of B on 1. Now, delta of F on 0 is F. Delta on B on 0 is A. F on 1 is F, B on 1 is D, so FD. Now consider this one, AF. Now check if AF is marked in this table or not. We have AF as unmarked, so keep it as unmarked. FD, check if FD is marked in this table or not. We have FD as marked. So if our condition is, if at least one is marked, then mark the cell FB. So mark the cell FB here. So the table becomes like this. Now let us consider another unmarked cell, which is FA. F and A. So delta of A comma 0 is B and delta of A comma 1 is C. So BC. B and C. Now check if BF is marked in this table or not. We have BF as marked in this table, so this is marked. And similarly, check if CF is marked. CF is marked in this table, so marked. We have both as marked, so mark FA. Similarly, CE. C and E. C and E. And delta of C comma 0 is E, and delta of E comma 0 is E. Delta of C comma 1 is F, and delta of E comma 1 is C. Sorry, delta of E comma 1 is F. So now check if EE is marked in this table. We have EE as unmarked, so this is unmarked. And FF is unmarked, so unmarked. We have both as unmarked states, so we cannot mark CE, so it remains unmarked. So leave CE as it is and go for next one, ED or DE. DE. Now D on 0 is E and D on 1 is F, and this is EF, and same EE and FF are both are unmarked, so leave DE as it is and go for next cell, DC. CEF, C on 0 goes to E, so it is correct, and C on 1 goes to F, this is also correct, and again the same one, EE is unmarked in this table, so don't mark it. FF is unmarked in this table, so don't mark it. So both, as both of them are unmarked, you cannot mark DC, so it remains unmarked. And DC, now check for BA or AB. AB. Delta of A comma 0 goes to B. Delta of A comma 1 goes to C. Delta of B comma 0 goes to A. Delta of B comma 1 goes to D. Now check if BA is marked in this table or not. We see that BA is not marked in this table, and check if CD is marked in this table or not. We have CD as unmarked in this table, so both of them are unmarked and we cannot mark AB. Now step 3 is completed and the table looks like this. Now if we compare the 3 examples which I have explained earlier on Myhill-Neroth theorem, everything is same up to step 3. The only change is in the earlier 2 examples we had only one state, only one cell which was unmarked, that is BC in the first example and AC in the second example. But if you look at this table after completion of step 3, we have 1, 2, 3 and 4 unmarked cells, which is different from the previous 2 examples. So what we have to do is, now consider this unmarked cells 1, 2, 3 and 4, AB, CD, CE and DE. Now if you look at these 4 unmarked cells, we observe that these 3 unmarked cells are dependent on each other. How? CD. These 2 unmarked cells are dependent on C because C is present in both of them. If you look at these 2, E is present in both of them. If you look at these 2, D is present in both of them. So, and also these 3 follow transitive, symmetric and reflexive property. So these 3 can be considered as equal states. So C, D, E are equal states. But here if we observe this unmarked cell AB, there is no dependency on these 3 cells. So AB is one independent cell. So mark AB as independent state which is different from these 3 states. So AB is one grouped cell or grouped state, and CDE are equal. As CDE are equal, these 3 belong to one other cell. Now CDE is different from this cell. So AB is over, CDE is over, and remaining one is F. Now AB is grouped together, CDE is grouped together, F is grouped together. I'll explain it again once more. Initially we have four unmarked cells, AB, CD, CE and DE. Now as in previous example, what we have to do is, if there are any unmarked cells, we have to group them together as we did in first example, that is considering BC as single state and AC as single state in example 2. But here, if you look at these four states, four cells, these three are dependent on each other. If you look at these two, C is common in both of them. If you look at these two, E is common in both of them. If you look at these two, D is common in both of them. And AB, if we consider this one, this is different and independent from these three cells. So we consider AB as one independent cell and we consider AB as one grouped state. And these three follow symmetric, reflexive and transitive property. So they are considered to be equal. If the cell satisfies symmetric, reflexive and transitive property, then those three cells are considered to be equal. So we have C, D, E. So consider them as equal. So AB is one independent state, C, D, E are equal. So they're grouped together and they're independent state. And remaining one is F. So F is one independent state. Now our DFA looks like this. And now we have to make the transitions. Now drawing the complete minimized DFA. AB is one state, CDE is one state, and remaining one is F is one state. Initial state is A, final state is CDE. So mark the state as final state, and A on 0 goes to B, A on 1 goes to C, B on 0 goes to A, B on 0 goes to A, B on 1 goes to D, B on 1 goes to D, C on 0 goes to E, C on 1 goes to F, D on 0 goes to E, D on 0 goes to E, D on 1 goes to F, D on 1 goes to F, E on 0 goes to E, E on 1 goes to F, F on 0 goes to F, F on 1 goes to F. So this is the required minimized DFA. We have done this based on Myhill-Nerod theorem, or also called as table filling method.